Hello, and welcome to this demo of UiPath Task Capture, an intelligent business process mapping tool that enables you to easily record, revise, and share documentation when looking to improve or automate a process. Let's start a new project by creating a new document. To begin mapping your process, start with one of these options. The first is Build Diagram. It gives you a more traditional drag-and-drop workflow and mapping experience. This option is ideal for building process maps documentation for more complex processes. Or you can select Capture Process, where Task Capture will automatically record the way you perform a process step by step with the built-in action recorder, which will easily generate a process map for you. Today, we will use the recorder as it saves time creating screenshots and manually capturing step-by-step details. Great, now we're ready to get started. Today, we're helping our HR team by documenting the step-by-step process to request time off through Workday. But this would work for any application that runs on your desktop or as a cloud application. As soon as we click the Capture Process button, the capturing wizard shows up. At this point, we need to ensure to close or minimize all the applications that we won't be using to avoid generating unnecessary screenshots. We can also launch and sign into the applications that we will be using as part of the absence recording process beforehand to avoid capturing sensitive information like passwords. When the environment is ready, we click the Start Capture button to start the capturing and automatically record all the steps that we perform in the HR application. By default, Task Capture generates screenshots for each action you perform, such as mouse clicks and keyboard activities. But you can adjust the level of detail within the settings menu. Consider the process in which we submit the request to take days off from work into the HR application, and then set up an auto-reply for emails. We are already logged into Workday, so let's get started with absence request process. For that, we click Absence. Click Request Absence. Select a day or a date range in the calendar and then submit the request. As the next step, to configure auto reply for emails, we navigate to already signed in Outlook. We click File, navigate to Automatic Replies, and configure an auto reply email. We can use the pause button to take short breaks to focus on something else. In case we want to add more details about a particular action, we can specify them in the action title or action description fields in the capturing panel. Alright, now that we've gone through the entire process, we'll click Stop Recording. Task Capture will then generate the process map for you. In less than a minute, we were able to create our first draft. At this point, you can rename the auto-generated titles of your steps or even combine the ones that belong to one part of your process. Now, let's take a second to review the screenshots and see if we need to make any changes. There is a whole editing toolkit available within Task Capture, and right now, we're going to add some visual markups to these screenshots. First, let's emphasize the critical steps of our process and the location that the action is taking place. While we're here, let's blur our personal information, as we plan on sharing this document out with other teams. And we'll quickly update the description of this action with the heading from the Workday screen. We finalized editing the recorded elements of our process. We have one additional step we want to be sure to include in this process map. For that, let's get back to the diagram editor page to add the final step of our process, a decision point for submitting one day or more than one day absence. We'll also overlay swim lanes to the map, which adds visual distinction for groups of actions, such as actions for a specific department or application. In our process map, the swim lanes will specify the actions required by the employee in Workday and Outlook. You can rename a swim lane by double-clicking the title and typing in the desired name. Perfect! Our process map is complete! Let's first save our documentation as a task capture project. That way, if the process needs to be updated in the future, we can quickly make those edits. Now, we have a few ways to share this with the team members. First, we can download the process map as a JPEG image to embed in another document, presentation, or email. Or we can export as process XAML file, creating an automation skeleton for Studio, which we'll show a bit later. We can also export the documentation as a Word document, or a process definition document, PDD. When outputting the PDD, you can provide key details about the process, like title or description. You can also pick from one of our documentation templates or use one of your own, along with adjusting image output properties. Now let's open the PDD. You'll see our documentation covers all of the critical elements of our process, and by default, includes a section for process overview, statistics tables, as is process map, as is actions, and others. Also, all the captured screenshots are included in the document together with annotations provided in Task Capture before. The PDD also includes the automatically populated metadata, such as clicks, time, etc. In 5 minutes, we created an accurate, detailed process documentation document that can be easily shared to teams across your business. For our needs, we will export this as a XAML file, creating an automation skeleton that can be opened within UiPath Studio, making it easy for our developers while accelerating our documentation to automation time. An integration between Task Captures and Automation Hub also enables you to send your documentation right to your existing automation project. Whether you're looking to build a drag-and-drop process map, or use our recorder to have one generated for you, visit us at uipath.com/taskcapture to start mapping.